on behalf of the bride and groom and their families, and I'm very proud to be part of the family at this particular wedding, and it's the first time I've ever married a grandchild, so I'm just delighted to be part of that. I want to welcome you to this celebration of the marriage of Brian Tate Martin and Morgan Rose Bancroft. Almost said Bancroft. Folks, we're gathered here today in the sight of God and the presence of family and friends to celebrate one of life's greatest moments, to recognize the worth and beauty of love, and to add our best wishes and blessings to the words which shall unite Tate and Morgan in holy matrimony. Marriage is an honorable covenant between a man and a woman, created and established by God. It is a biblical symbol of the relationship between Jesus Christ and his people. And because of that, it should be characterized by true love and devotion. Now, quite often at this part of the proceedings, they will ask a question about whether anybody has anything against this relationship. And Tim said he'd answer yes. So I'm not going to ask that question. Instead, I'm going to give you this little statement and ask you as a congregation to respond to it. The bonds this couple will make today are sacred and holy and should not be broken. But nearly every relationship is tested at one point or another by conflict, temptation, strife, and change. Will you, their loved ones, family, and friends, agree to help them keep those bonds holy, reminding them of their love for one another and helping them cross through those stressful periods?
Yes.
Thank you. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Lisa and I do.
Let's pray. Father, we thank you for this moment, this opportunity to come together to unite this man and woman in holy matrimony. We thank you for them. Thank you for their love for each other. Thank you for their love for you. And thank you for the family and friends that are here to support them today. And we just pray your blessing upon this marriage, upon this ceremony, and ask you to be with us. And may this be a blessed union, we pray, in Jesus' precious name. Amen. You may be seated. I'm going to call up David and share with us some thoughts regarding the bride and groom and others.
How are we here? Does not seem like it was very long ago. Watching a small tribe of children running into the magical lands of Wisteria in the backfield. And yet we are here. Thank you for the privilege of being emotional in front of you all. And thank you for asking me to share a little bit about what's important. The first century Christian Paul writes these words to the Ephesian church. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. This is a profound mystery. I don't know about you, but I find some relief in Paul's words. Because no one argues with the idea of love, how nice it feels to be appreciated and cared for by someone else. But the idea of marriage, the lifelong commitment to loving one person, is a profound mystery. By mystery, I mean the sense that marriage is a gamble or risk that scares us all to some extent. The idea of committing ourselves to a choice with so much gravity that will shape the direction and priorities of our lives, a decision that is so painful to back out of, yet still a mystery that we are strangely drawn to, despite the risk. Why are we drawn to this idea of an intimate relationship that can withstand the stress and strain of joy and pain, success and failure, growth and struggle? Well, let me return to the passage in Ephesians where I left off, For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. This is a profound mystery, but I am talking about Christ and the church. Paul points to the mystery of marriage as a real-life metaphor for appreciating the truly profound mystery of the way God relates to us as his family, which Christians refer to as the church. Why does Paul call this mystery profound? Well, even though all of us have turned away from God in our own unique ways, he remains turned towards us, eager to welcome us into his embrace, like the prodigal son's father who is scanning the horizon for any sign of his son's return. This is the message of Jesus that has been understood as good news for 2,000 years. Despite our choices to turn away from our Creator and live life on our own terms, God pursues us wherever we turn. Jesus was sent as the ultimate invitation for us, his life, death, and resurrection, a gift intended to turn us back towards the Father. The Spirit of God given to the faithful to empower us to enjoy living in his love. This is good news. Morgan and Tate, you stand before us this morning, facing each other, to declare publicly your choice to walk as one in love till death do you part. With this profound mystery of the gospel in mind, today is really the decision to keep turning towards each other in love, no matter what you face. Tate, when Morgan is tempted to turn away from your love, perhaps because of your short one-word answers, you must choose to go looking for her and gracefully invite her to face you fully again. Paul tells us that the best way to demonstrate that you are fully turned towards Morgan will be by proving that she is the most important priority in your life. Morgan, when Tate is tempted to turn away from your love or roll his eyes when you go on about the latest Shakespearean tragedy, you must choose to go looking for him and gracefully invite him to face you fully. Paul goes on to say in Ephesians that the best way to demonstrate that you are fully turned towards Tate will be by demonstrating your deep respect for his abilities. I'd like to leave you with a prayer blessing. As your two lives become one, may the power of the Father keep you turned fully towards each other. May the sacrificial love of the Son keep you fully turned towards each other. And may the wisdom of the Spirit of God keep you fully turned towards each other. Amen.
Thank you, Jay. By the way, the bride has asked that no pictures be taken during the ceremony. The photographer is here to do that, and they will be available online in a very short order. So just keep your cameras in your pocket or wherever. Okay, well, you're already facing each other and holding hands. This is good. Tate, as you take Morgan to be your wife, you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect her, forsaking all others and holding only to her as long as you both shall live.
I do.
Morgan, as you take Tate to be your husband, do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect him, forsaking all others and holding only to him as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Tate, repeat after me. I take Tate you Morgan to be my wife.
I take you Morgan to be my wife.
My constant friend.
My constant friend.
My faithful partner in life.
My faithful partner in life.
And my one true love.
And my one true love.
In the presence of God and these witnesses.
In the presence of God and these witnesses.
I give you my sacred promise to stay by your side as your faithful husband.
I give you my sacred promise to stay by your side as your faithful husband.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
Through good times and bad.
Through good times and bad.
I promise to love you.
I promise to love you.
Comfort you and encourage you.
Comfort you and encourage you.
Laugh with you and cry with you. Grow with you in mind and spirit.
Grow with you in mind and spirit.
Always be open and honest with you.
Always be open and honest with you.
And cherish you for as long as we both shall live.
And cherish you for as long as we both shall live.
You ready, Morgan? I, Morgan, take you, Tate, to be my husband.
I, Morgan, take you, Tate, to be my husband.
My constant friend.
My constant friend.
My faithful partner in life.
My faithful partner in life.
And my one true love.
And my one true love.
In the presence of God and these witnesses.
In the presence of God and these witnesses.
I give you my sacred promise to stay by your side as your faithful wife.
I give you my sacred promise to stay by your side as your faithful wife.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
Through good times and bad.
Through good times and bad.
I promise to love you.
I promise to love you.
Comfort you and encourage you.
Comfort you and encourage you.
Laugh with you and cry with you.
Laugh with you and cry with you.
Grow with you in mind and spirit.
Grow with you in mind and spirit.
Always be open and honest with you.
Always be open and honest with you.
And cherish you for as long as we both shall live.
And cherish you for as long as we both shall live.
Now we're going to exchange the rings. Wedding rings are an outward and visible sign of your endless love for each other and the permanent relationship you are entering into today, as promised in the vows you have just made to each other. Tate, repeat after me as you place this ring on Morgan's finger. With this ring, I pledge my love to you.
With this ring, I pledge my love to you.
Morgan, repeat after me as you place this ring on Tate's finger. With this ring, I pledge my love to you.
With this ring, I pledge my love to you.
Inasmuch as the two of you have agreed to live together in holy matrimony, have promised to love each other by these vows, the joining of your hands, and the giving of these rings, I now declare you to be husband and wife. Let no one separate them, for God has joined them together. Congratulations. You may kiss your bride. The documents, and we'll be entertained for a few minutes here while that's happening, and then we'll be back with some more words. Just a few announcements. The bridal party will be leaving for about an hour to take some pictures, but we'll be back for brunch, hopefully at about 11:30. We're right on schedule, so that's good. There will be coffee served in the lounge at the back straight as you go out the doors to your, well, to your left if you're coming out the side doors. Back in the lounge, there will be coffee served for the guests in the meantime, and brunch will be served in the dining room at about 11:30 or as soon thereafter as the bridal party returns. And I know that Morgan is notorious for her timeliness. I've had a few meetings with them and she's always been there early, so that's great. And I know that Kate, unless it sleeps in, is pretty good. Just a little final advice to the couple. Kate and Morgan, as you enter this marriage and as you have this day affirmed your love for each other, I ask that you always remember to cherish one another as special and unique individuals. That you respect the thoughts, ideas, and suggestions of the other. Learn to forgive, do not hold grudges, and live each day sharing it together. From this day forward, you shall be each other's comfort and refuge. Your marriage strengthened by your love and respect for each other. And so just remember that you're now each other's. You're one. One in Christ and one is a man and a woman, the way God created us to be. So let's close in prayer. Father, we do thank you for this union. And I thank you for both Morgan and Kate. I thank you for their love for you. And as they love you, we know that their love for each other will be strong and vital. And so we commit them to you, commit everyone present here to you, and pray your blessing upon us as we spend some more time together and as we join for a meal in a little while. Just ask that you would be with us, and may this whole event be just one that honors and glorifies you, we pray. And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, it's my great privilege to introduce to you, for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Tate and Morgan Martin.